Hi everyone, I'm Cody at W3AMG with BridgeCom Systems, and today we are going to be showing you how to configure a scan list for analog and a receive group list for digital on your Anytone radio. Awesome. So first step, go ahead and plug in your radio, plug in the programming cable to your computer and then to the radio. After that, we're going to go ahead and read from the radio. Alrighty, so we are going to read from our radio. So make sure your radio is selected in the COM port section there. Go ahead and select it and then click that read from radio button right here to the left and just click OK and then go ahead and read the other data. Awesome, there we go. This is going to make sure everything's synchronized between your radio and your computer so you won't have any band errors. After that, we're going to go and set up our list. So you can click on scan list here and you can see we have one created. We could create another one. Let's say make a list two. And we could add whatever channels we'd like to add. Let's say I add a few channels here. This is traditionally used for analog systems. These are obviously digital channels, but let's say I have my NOAA weather channels. This will be perfect to add them to a scan list. Once you're done, just go ahead and click OK. And great, we've created a scan list. Now in your channel section, if you're making a channel and you want to add it to a scan list, you can actually do that here. You can select what scan list to add it to. When you're making your channel. So if you want to add some as you're creating them, you can do that. Now, what about if you want to scan digital channels, basically allowing you to scan through without having to key into each one and then disconnect and go find a different channel if you want to scan for digital activity? Well, there's a great way to do that with a scan group. So go ahead and open up digital tab, and it's called a receive group call. This is what you're looking for. There you go. So receive group call. You can go ahead and click on this. And from here, you can add different talk groups. So let's say I want to add this one and that one. Now they do have to be group calls. They can't be a private call, but if it's a group call, you can add them to a receive group. So go ahead and click OK. And then after that, you can actually use that on your radio. Now, if we go back up here to the channels, we can, let's say we open up one that's a group call. You can see here under the receive group list section, we can choose what list it goes to. So again, just like the scan list, you can add them when you're creating your channels. After that's all done, go ahead and write this information to your radio. Now I will give you a quick tip. What will be super helpful for you, go into the optional settings and go to key function. Once you're there, go ahead and assign a couple keys. Let's see if we make it P1 long key, we'll do a couple keys here, for your scan list. This will make it super easy to activate your scan list versus having to go in the menu each time. There you go. Go ahead and select scan. Awesome. There we go. So now at this point we can click OK and then go ahead and write this to our radio. There we go. Write data complete. Awesome, here we go. So on the radio at this point, we've set up our scan list. Go ahead and go to menu, then we'll go down to scan. And from here, you can go ahead and turn scan on and off. Now in this case, we've already created a button for it, but this is where you would traditionally do it. And then you can also select your scan list. So if we select one, let's say we want scan list two, go ahead and select that. And here's a tip, if there's a lot of items in the scan list, go ahead and just hit the up arrow. And that will take you back around to the bottom. And you can press this select current list and that will select the list for you. Once you have one selected, you are free to use it. So if we turn this on right now, just like that, we can see we start scanning. If these are analog channels, this will allow you to scan for activity. So there we go. Just go ahead and press the red button to turn that off. And there you have it. Awesome, there we go. So we have our scan list. Now what about receive group calls? There is an option if you go into digital. This is more for digital operation. What you can do is go to receive group call list, click on that, and go ahead and create one. Once you're there, just give it a name, and you can actually add, so it looks like we already have some in, but these would normally be over here. Just go ahead and add whatever group calls you'd like to add to it. Now these are going to be group talk groups basically. So if you have talk groups in your talk group list, all those group IDs are going to show up here. So you can add whichever ones you would like. Let's just go ahead and add some here. Then you can click OK. Now, to actually use this, we will have to assign it to a channel. So go back over to your channels. It's going to be similar to how we did the scan list, but work a little bit different in operation. So if we go here, let's say we want to pick this channel. We can go ahead and select Receive Group Call List right here and select the one we'd like. Now, with this channel, not only are we going to be able to access the talk group that's assigned it, we'll have access to that entire receive group. So if you wanted to listen to maybe a large area or maybe multiple states at once, you can do it this way. There are other ways to do this through the Brandmeister backend, which we'll show you how, but this is one way. Then after that, go ahead and click OK. You will want to assign a button for your scan list operation. Easiest way to do that is go into optional settings and go to key function. I've already done this here, but in this case, P1 long key, you can save it to anything. Go ahead and make one of your buttons take you to scan. This is going to make it much easier for you when you're actually using the scan function. After that, just go ahead and make sure your radio is plugged in and connected, which it is. And then click the button to the right, write to radio, click OK, and then write the other data. After that, go ahead and click OK. We can unplug our radio here. There we go, we'll unplug our radio, wait for it to boot back up. Awesome, there we go. So at this point, go ahead and click on menu, and I'll show you how to select one. So if we go down here, let's go to scan. You can select scan. Now, if you don't have a key assigned to it, you can turn it off via this option right here. You can turn scan on or off. Now, we actually have to select a scan list before we can turn it on. So go to scan list. Now, if you have multiple, just go ahead and find the one you'd like here and click on it. Once you're there, if you have a lot of things in that scan list, you may have to go a long way to find them. So in this case, these would be all of our analog scan lists or scan channels. So go ahead and press the up arrow key. And this will actually take you back around to the bottom of the list. And at the bottom of the list, you'll have a few options, including select current list. So go ahead and hit that. Now your list is selected. So once you've selected one, you can turn it on and use it. So we can go ahead and turn our scan list on just like that. And now, there you go. Hey, look at that, it's working.